Hello students, today I will explain you about the general characters of Kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera is the first kingdom in five kingdom classification. They are unicellular organisms with prokaryotic cellular organization. Means it is made up of single cell and nucleus here is not well developed. These are omnipresent. They are found in all types of environment which are not generally inhabited by other living beings. Few are photoautotrophs, that is, they prepare their food in presence of light, and some are chemoautotrophs. They prepare their food with the help of chemicals, but majority are heterotrophic in nature. For food, they are dependent on others. These organisms do not have well-defined nucleus. DNA exists as a simple double-stranded circular single chromosome called as nucleoid. Smaller circular molecule of DNA as extra chromosomal genetic element is called plasmid. Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycans, also called murine, which is a polymer of sugar and amino acid. Membrane bound organelles, example mitochondria, chloroplast, endoplasmic reticulum, these are all absent. Ribosomes are smaller in size, that is 70S. Mode of reproduction is asexual, that is binary fission. Your single cell divides equally to form two cells or budding. Very rarely, sexual reproduction is by conjugation method. Means here, the two bacterias comes together and they exchange genetic material of each other. Morphologically, bacterias are categorized into four groups: spherical, that is coccus, rod shape called as bacillus, comma kidney shape called as vibrio, and spirally arranged called as spirillum. On the basis of evolution, Kingdom Monera is classified into Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. Archaebacteria are mostly found in extreme environment, that is, from volcanic craters to salty lakes and hot springs, and hence they are called extremophiles. Bacteria that can withstand high salinity, high salty environment are called halophiles. Those that withstand extreme temperature are known as thermophiles. Methanogenic bacteria found in gut of ruminant cow and buffaloes helps in production of methane gas in biogas plant. Eubacteria, they are true bacteria, cell wall made up of peptidoglycans, some are autotrophs and most of them are heterotrophs. Autotrophs can be photosynthetic. They prepare their food in presence of light. And here, example chlorobium, that is green sulfur bacteria, chromatium, purple sulfur bacteria, and some are chemosynthetic, that is sulfur bacteria Theobacillus. Mostly multicellular filamentous form lives in fresh water, and the body is covered by mucilaginous sheet. Genetic material is typically prokaryotic. Photosynthetic pigments are chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, and xanthophyll. Heterocyst is present, which helps in nitrogen fixation. Heterotrophs are the most abundant. Some are decomposers. They break large molecules into simple molecules or minerals. Some are anaerobes, which helps in curdling of milk. that is lactobacilli. Some does nitrogen fixation, azotobacter. Some in antibiotic production like streptomyces and composting and degrading oil. Some are pathogens, that is disease causing, like typhoid, cholera, tuberculosis and tetanus.